Hello, everybody. This is Theron. Welcome to Minecraft 1.9 Snapshot Tour. Today is December 9th, 2015, and they put out a new snapshot today. It is Minecraft 15W50A, and they improved some of the performance issues. They broke mobs. They broke spiders. Look at these guys. Hey, where'd you come from? Were you hiding up there? Oh, look at that. The spiders don't hit as much as they did, although I think they were able to hit you at times when they couldn't have. And look at this guy just spinning around. Let me turn on the light here. It's like he should be coming at me. He's got a path towards me. But if they can't super reach you, they kind of act like the zombies, where the zombies just do their little Macarena dance. And woohoo! I got levels. So I modified things a little bit here. I put some half slabs in so that you can see into it without allowing light in. Makes it a little easier, especially with the guys getting up here with the full blocks here. It was kind of difficult, especially the full block right here. The full blocks here, it was difficult to see them when they got up into this corner. So now it's relatively easier. And I'm trying to manage the light level. So when I'm standing here and the light's off, there's a spawnable amount of light here. Light 5. But nothing's going to spawn because I'm standing here. I will walk, when I walk away, I turn the lights here on. And the light here is now at 10. So that minimizes my spawning. Woohoo. Came down here to repair some stuff, but everything's all my mending stuff is all repaired. So let's put some stuff away. Made a little chest here. I noticed I had a spider jockey. Came here and I killed the spider. I wasn't patient enough. I didn't let the spider push him up into the ceiling and kill the skeleton first. I killed the spider and the skeleton did his little dance bit. So there seems to be an issue with the mob AI in this snapshot. So I wouldn't be surprised to see another, like a 50B snapshot tomorrow. So anyway, one other nice thing about the position of this little grinder is that while I'm up there, these spawn chunks, at least some of them, are loaded and this farm is active. Look at that. It's not hugely productive, but then I don't need it to be. Hey dude, how are you doing? All right, so I'm gonna go back up top and show you some other stuff. Okay, so I got some birch trees going here. I've been doing some farming. I moved the spruce tree here because it was blocking the view of this. I should probably redo that. Let me try that again. I have some birch trees here. Sorry. Clock, clock, clock. I have some birch trees here. Been doing some wood farming and some birch farming, and I removed the spruce tree that was up here because it was blocking the view of this. That worked a little better. Anyway, I built a house. So I said last time, or in a previous recent video, I don't do a lot of building. I don't consider myself a builder, and I wanted to build a little house and was trying some stuff, and you probably saw some, you may have seen some stuff in the creative world. I was building, trying to build some sort of big circular skies, fancy modern looking stuff. And this is what I settled on. So this is based on the Monsanto House of the Future. It was an exhibit at Disneyland from the late 50s into the 1960s. It was gone by the time I ever went to Disneyland. But the idea was that it was a prefab house, mostly made out of plastics. Monsanto, which is today known for their sort of GMO crops and whatnot, and don't have a particularly sterling reputation, they sponsored exhibits at Disneyland to sort of push, you know, science and promote, you know, positive views of the work that they were doing, a lot of which had to do with building materials and science education. So the idea was this house could be built out of prefab segments on a small foundation. So this would be a, I've got here, it's a 7x7 foundation, which is, I upsized things a little bit, which I'll explain why. But this is mostly to my Minecraft scale. I believe it was a 16x16 foot segments that they built it in. So 16x16 foot foundation. And then the house was built out of these modules. So there was a center module and then these wing modules. So there are four wing modules around the center module. And then they had steps that went up like this. And I'm building it out of this diorite because, well, I like the diorite. I think it's kind of a pretty block. But I don't have nearly enough quartz. I would build it out of quartz. And when I build it elsewhere, I probably will. So then you come in here. And so you have the center section, which we'll talk about in a little bit. But each of these wings then is a little area of the house. And in the exhibit, which I have some pictures. I think I'll put one into the video right here. And then this section here was kind of the living room. So I put a little storage, like, you know, this is the mud room or whatever. You come in and you put your stuff away. So I'm like, oh, well, take this stuff out of my pocket. And I'll keep the valuables and stuff here. So I got my valuables chest. I'll show you where the rest is in a minute. Then you come in here. We're going to work on this here on camera a little bit. You turn left, and in the original, this was two bedrooms. It was divided down the middle. One of the problems with the Minecraft scale building is that walls kind of have to be a whole meter thick, which would only have left a couple of blocks for the bedrooms. And I don't really need two bedrooms, so I made this one. I put a little bench here, unfortunately purely decorative, but put a little bench just to divide things up a little bit, make this into its own space. In general, I like the open floor plan, but I wanted to sort of make little spaces here. And it's getting dark out, so let's go to bed. I do like the view from here. All right, and then over here we have a little bit of a brewing area, of a brewing set. I'm cheating a little bit by just putting a block of water underneath the brewing stand, but I don't have enough room really to make a full automated brewing system, and this is really enough for what I'm doing here. I brought up one of the dogs and I named him. Hi. Give me a head tilt. Oh, thank you. So then I've got, you know, space here for some brewing ingredients, space here for some potions, and I have a little space here where I can do some other stuff. I'm not quite sure what I'll do. One thing that I noticed that over the last couple snapshots, they've been adding a lot of sounds to the game. So when a potion brews, they actually added a sound, which is kind of cool. Wait for it. Wait for it. Wait for it. Okay, yeah, that's kind of cute. They added a few other sounds, and they changed some sounds too. The trap doors don't sound like doors anymore. Anyway, and they have different opening and closing sounds. And then over here are the library, enchanting area, crafting table, and an anvil and whatnot. My ender chest, which is kind of full, but I think I have a good assortment of stuff in there. It's a good all-purpose ender chest. You notice I'm having some lag spikes. It's not, the performance is much improved, but the it's not awesome. And notice they have this alt hidden FPS thing, they added this graph, and it shows you what your frame rate is, and they have the two lines there. Basically, the lower that red graph, the better. And I've got a lot of stuff. Now, this isn't, you know, the most powerful gaming system in the world. I'm playing this on a laptop. But spent a lot of time with the graph there over the 30 FPS. And some of the spikes are quite tall. And every now and then, I'll have one where the spike is just gargantuan. And the game just sort of freezes up for a couple seconds, which isn't good. It makes the Nether still pretty darn dangerous. I need, for some of my outside plans here, I need some more end rods. The end rods, which I need more blaze rods to make. I'm planning on putting some around here, making it kind of neon, because I've got the inside, it kind of looks like fluorescent lights. I want to put end rods along here and underneath here, but I need 120 some. I need a bunch, and I only have like 20 blaze rods at the moment, which will get me part of the way there. But I want to be able to light up the ground out here with all these torches, and I am thinking of putting kind of over here a little flower garden, just putting in some flowers of different types, and maybe over here and over here, I want to make this sort of utility space. So I want to put in some crops, and I don't know, maybe I don't want to like put fences around here so much, so I don't want to move the animals up, but I want to do something with the land around it so that we're taking advantage of the space under here. But I need light on the ground there so stuff doesn't spawn. Okay, and then one other thing to show you here. I put this trap door in here, and woo! Okay, this looks familiar. This is my old area. I'm sort of reorganizing and taking out chests and moving stuff around. And where am I putting all my stuff? Ouch. I'm putting it over here. So I'm building mass storage area over here. This is my warehouse. And this is sort of all building blocks of different types. So I've got andesite, diorite, granite, gravel, dirt, sand, clay, which I don't have a lot because I've yet to find a mesa biome. Miscellaneous stuff, so I've got the mushroom blocks, like a cactus and stuff. Some of this has to move. And then I've just got stone, right? And I'll probably do a thing of like stone variants. And probably I may expand this out a little bit farther to put in a few more chests and put in a stack of chests for like per blocks and whatnot. So my idea is that whatever this is applies to the entire stack. And the stuff down below might be different, or in this case, because I have a lot of just stone, this is all these are stone. I don't think this is empty. So I've got 6, almost 7 double chests full of stone. This is going to be mostly stuff that mobs drop, right? And I had a little thing of like fish stuff down here. I have to take some of those pufferfish up to my brewing stand, and then this is going to be kind of utility stuff. So this is, oh look, slime. Oh, I have some slime to put in there. Nice. Coal, redstone stuff. So this is all like redstone blocks. Down here's stuff used with and for redstone. Water, ice, snow, buckets, that kind of thing. And then I've got lava. I've got a bunch of lava. Ender pearls, and then this is like Nether stuff. Probably rearrange this a little bit. I've got some more things in here, but I've got wood over here. Normally I would put wood with the back blocks there, but I use the wood much more frequently than I do the stone and other blocks, so I wanted it a little bit more easily accessible. And laying out this way, I can tell which ones I have more need for. I want to build up my supply of birch wood, because that and dark oak are the wood logs that I have the least of. And I've got saplings down here, and of course those build up as I do my harvesting. And then this is just stuff I make out of wood. And if I need to make more for that I will. So I can expand this back farther this way, and I can expand this out farther this way. And I've put these end rods up here above the chest, because the chest, of course, needs transparent blocks above it to open. So the end rods allow it to open, but also give it light. So I don't have any torches back here, and it's kind of cool. So that's those are most of the changes I made. And then I put this ladder down coming from the center of the house so I could get down into the warehouse area without having to go outside. That's kind of nice. I put a jukebox here. That's a little low. Let me adjust that. There we go. Okay. So one thing I wanted to do in the Disneyland exhibit, I'm gonna need to get some more chests. This area here was like, this half of the area was a kitchen, and this half was bathrooms. I don't need bathrooms. This is Minecraft. Nobody goes to the bathroom. But I wanted to do something here. So I wanted to get some stuff and lay in and sort of build a little kitchen area out. Not that anyone uses kitchens really in Minecraft, but there were some stuff I wanted to lay out. And I wanted to make some of it utilitarian, so we put some furnaces in here. But the cool thing is, you can now stack trapdoors on blocks in ways in 1.9 that you couldn't before. So that almost looks like cooktops on top of an oven. I thought that was kind of cool. And then you could also put a trapdoor on a side like this and fold it. Whoa, huge leg spike. Fold it down. Yeah, nice. So I had kind of a layout here. I need some more chests. Let me go get those real quick. Be right back. One thing I was trying to do. Come on. And they changed the way this works too, which is nice. When you have ladders going up to a trap door like this, you used to get stuck on top of the ladder, but now you can climb all the way up, which is nice. Tried to put in tripwire across here so that while I was climbing up, this could open. Unfortunately, you can't put the tripwire in at this block level because that ladder takes up the space. So you can't have the ladder and the tripwire across there. But I found, I almost don't even need the trapdoor because you can sort of walk over it at speed and not fall in. You have to sort of line yourself up pretty carefully. And if I replace that with a ladder, it'll be extra. But I think it's kind of cool to... Oops. If you're on roughly centered, hit the button, woo! And then trapdoor closes behind itself. Okay, so this was kind of my idea of a sink and then a little extra cleaning sink. I put it in a hopper because it could provide some storage, but I also was thinking of putting a whole pile of hoppers going down here, and this could actually lead as a sorting area, so I could dump stuff in here and have it go down into my storage area, which we'll see. I don't know if that's a particularly good idea or not, one of the things that they had in the House of the Future, and I want ways to be able to walk in and out of here, so I want this to sort of make a little space there, but still provide an open floor plan. But one of the things that they had was kind of cool, in that they had storage. Is that in the right place? No, it is not. Come on. But they had storage that came down from the ceiling, and it would come down automatically, and you could sort of it would come down, and the refrigerator, there was no refrigerator per se, there was simply a oops, that's not where I want those. The refrigerator was what they called it a cold zone. And so the refrigerator was a storage area that came down from above that was refrigerated, and you could keep all your foods in there. So you could, instead of having to go to the library, to the refrigerator, you could just press a button. The refrigerator would come down from the ceiling. And, I really wish you could put hoppers upside down, because I put them upside down over this, and it would look like fence. It would look like a hood. Oh man, I'm just breaking everything today. It's one downside to the end rods is they're easily broken. Okay, let me fix that real quick. Pop, and then put up my storage here. So the idea was that the storage would come down and you could get to it. So I wanted to put foodstuffs up here, and I still have visibility from here out. So like if I had guests over, they could come out and join me. And I think I even was like putting that down. So it's kind of an eating surface. So I can eat from here. I could be cooking here. This come up to give you an extra work room. This is like chopping block, you know, work table sort of thing. And so here's my little kitchen. It's not the greatest thing in the world, but I can get in and out of it, and it sort of it sort of adds to the detail. It's not too cluttered. I think that's kind of cool. And I can walk around it. And this, I can walk around this, but it kind of gets in the way, so you can leave it down. So here's my little kitchen. It's nighttime. Let's go to bed. It still looks pretty cool from this vantage point. All right, and I'll probably move the foodstuffs. I haven't moved up, so I'll probably have one of these be like my plant food, and one of these be my animal food, and then I don't know, put stuff like cakes and whatnot up in one of them. Don't know, but that's the basic. That's the basic layout on my house of the future. So, let's see. Anything else to show you? Birch trees are easy to get lots of wood from, because they'll grow close together. Again, they will actually grow right next to one another, but this lets you give light and make sure that everything grows. They no branches, so it's easy to harvest. They don't grow super tall, so again, it's easy to harvest, and they're pretty good with the saplings. The jungle trees are the tricky ones, because they're super stingy. Oh, that one's a little taller. Yeah, so. Oh yeah, let's go refill my water. Let's go put this stuff up. Okay, let's go refill my water bucket, because I put it in with the cauldron. Put a little bit more volume there. Ooh, oh, already got saplings. So anyway, let those leaves decay. What else to show you? So I said the Nether is still not super awesome. It's very, there's a lot of lag spikes. It's dangerous. I went in to see if it was improved. It's better, but it's not awesome. So I'm not going back in there for the time being. I'm hoping there's a bee snapshot tomorrow. I need to go in here. I got a lot more villagers, and I need to go in here and do some cleanup. Huh. There's a librarian here. Hey, dude. And he's got respiration 2. Not awesome, but we need to develop him. And I've got some guys who can go away. But we'll do that later. It's a little bit tricky. I've got 3 iron golems now, so I have to be careful not to accidentally punch the villagers. Mob farm's working okay. Still haven't figured out the optimal distance, but you can see they're kind of raining down. They kind of come in waves. And I sort of emptied this out earlier, so there's not a ton of stuff. But I'm starting to build up a collection of, you know, some good gunpowder, so we can make that bone meal. Make TNT bone meal, plenty of stuff. One other thing I noticed about, I don't know if it's this snapshot or the 43C snapshot that I was playing, the hopper duplication bug is back. Notice that all the sugarcane in here is grown. This hopper is full. That's everything I put in. This hopper somehow magically has one more sugarcane in it. Woohoo! So it just popped off a bunch. I've got a few that'll despawn there, but that's okay. I have more sugarcane than I know what to do with right now. Not doing that much trading with librarians. But if we go here and look, double chest completely filled. And this hopper, I pulled some out to make some paper, so I've been pulling from here. So there's, the system is almost full. So it just kind of chugs along. I don't think there's anything else too much. I do like the way that looks. And if I put the end rods around it, notice I've got some torches on the roof to keep stuff from spawning up there because I don't want to really slab the roof. Although the center section was actually slightly pyramid shaped on the actual house at Disneyland. So I could put some half slabs up on top of there and sort of help build that shape a little bit. But I think if I put the end rods around it, it'll give it kind of a neon sort of look, which wasn't the original, but I think it'll look pretty cool. And again, it'll let me get rid of all of these torches. So, and I still have the entrance here where I can reach, get down into the basement, the warehouse area, portal, farm, doggies. I still need to name these guys. I got red and green. I want to name these other two. I don't know what I'm going to do with them. Yeah, so I can still get down here from outside. And when I clear out this, like, so these are my food things. So this is like the plant food, and this is the animal food, plus wool, which I'll probably put in its own thing. And then this is just miscellaneous stuff. My Frostwalker boots, which I should probably put in my valuables chest upstairs. And then miscellaneous stone derivative things, which I'll put over there by the stone chest. And I'll clean the stuff out. So I'll have to move over all the purr blocks. And this has flowers and dyes and stuff. Once I get this all cleared out, I'll probably fill this in or wall it off. So this will be the edge of my basement. And I'll clean up the walls so that they're more of a consistent type right now. I mean, down over here, I kind of made everything stone. Over here, I still have some stuff. You know, I've got this granite sticking here. It's kind of ugly. So we'll make it all consistent and wall that off so that this is the wall. So I can come up here and either go outside or down into the mining area. So I think it'll work. So anyway, that's about all I have right now. I haven't been playing a huge amount because, oh, when I come up top, I can just push the button and it'll close. Woo! So I'm glad I built out the kitchen here. And again, this, my plan is to have that come down. It's a couple blocks over here. Down here, and then that can feed into a filtering system. And maybe certain types of blocks I can throw in there and then just have them automatically filter. Not necessarily into these chests, but into maybe other chests over here. Don't know. Don't have a huge amount of room this direction. I have some. but we can come up with some interesting things to do. I don't think I had anything else really to show, so we'll leave it at that. Thanks for watching. I haven't been playing a huge amount, just simply because the game's been pretty unplayable the last few snapshots. Things are improved here, but they're not perfect. And again, the Nether is very dangerous still, and I can only imagine the end is probably not so great. So hopefully they are working on improving performance. So hopefully they'll get that all cleaned up, and we'll get into. Oh, I let everything despawn. Dang it. Okay, no problem. I got plenty of birch saplings. So anyway, I think that's it. We'll call that an episode. Thank you for watching, and I will see you later. Bye.